Hi, I'm Jim Hendricks with Trailer Boats Magazine, and I'm here with Bruce Hawkins from Stingray Boats in Orlando at the Marine Dealer Expo and Conference. Bruce, we're here with the 235DR. It's a new boat for Stingray this year. Tell us a little bit about the boat, who it's designed for, and what some of the thought that went into the design.
I'd be happy to, Jim. The biggest thing with this boat, it's a new model. It was introduced at model changeover in July, so it's on an all-new hull, all-new deck. It's a liner boat, so it's a fiberglass liner. Mm-hmm. The best thing about it is that we call it the easy come, easy go. If you remember the song from right. George Strait, right. Easy Come, Easy Go, the entrance and exit out of the boat are real accommodating on either end. You've got a bow boarding ladder. You can come in over the bow. It's got a washdown on the bow. You've got a walk-through transom, which Stingray, if you've followed our line for any period of time, has had a step-through transom. It's usually stepping up onto a step just above the swim platform and then over into the boat, and that maintained the integrity of the seating. But with the walk-through, that's been a popular introduction into the industry over the years. And so we've had requests for the walk-through. We still have the step-through, some of the bigger boats, but we've gone to the walk-through entry.
I gotcha. Well, let's take a look inside this boat and see some of the great features that Stingray has incorporated.
The first thing I'd like to show you in that easy come, easy go entry is a forward compartment. We have actually two steps that are forward. And the first compartment is holding a boarding ladder, three-step boarding ladder, and we also have an anchor locker integrated within the boarding ladder receptacle. Under the second compartment, again acting as a step, is a fender locker. So it'll hold two 6-inch diameter boat fenders conveniently out of the way. Another feature that you'll find as we develop new products with Stingray is we're always looking to how can we enhance the boating experience in the bow of the boat. And in this case, we have incorporated twin speakers and along with stainless steel dual cup holders on both the port and starboard side of the boat. The last feature that I'd like to talk about in the bow is the what we call the cavernous seat bases. We have a lot of storage underneath both the port and starboard bow seats. You also notice the curved nature as you walk into the bow. This gives you a lot more leg room. It also, if you're sitting, but not only if you're sitting, if you're trying to maneuver from the bow back to the cockpit. This is a very functional head that we have on the port side of the boat. It's got a fiberglass door. We have the stereo tucked neatly away inside to keep it out of the weather, out of moisture. And then, of course, you can see some of the storage cabinets down below. Looking at the dash as you come into the cockpit area, you're immediately drawn to the two-tier, two-level dash. We have a full complement of gauges. The center gauge actually has four gauges in one, which has become a very popular gauge to monitor fuel levels, temp, volts, and so forth. We also, in all of our boats, have a engine hour meter built into the tachometer. So there's not a Stingray boat that's out there that won't have this engine hour meter. A couple of other features that you find in a Stingray, especially our larger models, I'm going to start with is a flip-up bolster seat. Features a 36-ounce vinyl with prefix protectant, so all of our upholsteries have the prefix for if there's stains or marks, they're easily removed. But what's probably more important for the seat is the flip-up bolster. If someone wants to sit up a little higher as you're boating, we all know the old method of taking out a life ring or a life jacket and sitting up just to get a higher perspective. But also, if you're docking from a driver's standpoint, you're able to stand behind the wheel without the intrusion of the steering wheel. We have an easy opening sun deck. It's very similar to opening the hood of your automobile, but the latch is reached very easily. It has shock assist to once you release the latch for the entire sun deck to rise. You'll notice that on this liner, on the deck liner, we also have built in a storage compartment that is above the engine compartment. Kind of capping off the story with the 235DR, again, is back to our transom walkthrough. It's a 15-inch wide companionway. You'll notice it has a step down into the cockpit, and you'll notice it has a step down onto the swim platform. The swim platform is integrated. It's an oversized platform, and it's great for water sports activity.
Bruce, thanks so much. You know, I've been aboard this boat, got an opportunity to test it near your plant in South Carolina. I'm very impressed. The speed, the handling, the smooth ride of this boat is just phenomenal, and I wish you guys the best of luck going out with the 235DR.
Thank you, Jim. I appreciate it. One last point, now that you mentioned the performance and the speed, this one has a 300 horsepower. It's a Volvo Penta dual prop, and the top speed wide open throttle is almost 59 miles an hour, 58.6 to be exact.
Well, so I can attest to that. I was out there, and I got it up to that speed. Okay. So, hey, we'll see you out on the water.
Sounds good. Thank you, Jim.